Hey guys, welcome back. It's Charlie and we're doing the 420 Bible study and Torah tour. And we're going back to that special night in Gethsemane where Jesus was taken into prisoner. And he did all of that to show us how to pray and worship in the temple, which is now the body, with the daily offerings, which is the daily bread. Turns out the food that we knew nothing about, it's the aroma of cannabis. Yep. So we're going to go back to Matthew and start going step by step with what Jesus says to remind ourselves, like Moses told everybody back then. And then Moses said, what are you guys going to do when I'm not here? Because you sure as don't listen to me while I'm here. So technically, we could be like Paul in prison. But he wasn't in prison, he wasn't in chains. We didn't learn the book correctly. He was in Cain. Not insane, but in Cain. And that's the difference in the incense. How do you spell this book? Well, if we're all under a curse, does anybody know the blessing or the magic potion to undo the curse? Yes. That's why Emmanuel came. The Greeks changed his name to Jesus and Christ for the Messiah and the Anointed One. But all that dwindles down to he is Jewish. He says he's a prophet. The woman at the well says he's a prophet. So what does the prophet say in this book? Well, let's see in Matthew if we can pick it up and what he says as we go through the fulfillment of the law to start the step-by-step walking with a Jewish person by faith, that if we hang out with them enough and we get to know their daily habits and their Jewish customs, then by faith and enjoying their food, we can learn how to worship their God, which is Hashem, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, and the God of Jesus Christ. Baruch Hashem. The fulfillment of the law. Do not think that I have come to abolish the law or the prophets. I have not come to abolish them, but to fulfill them. For truly I tell you, until heaven and earth disappear, not the smallest letter, not the least stroke of a pen will by any means disappear from the law until everything is accomplished. Therefore, anyone who sets aside one of the least of these commands and teaches accordingly will be called least in the kingdom of God. But whoever practices and teaches these commands will be called great in the kingdom of heaven. For I tell you that unless your righteousness surpasses that of the Pharisees and the teachers of the Torah law and Moses, you will certainly not enter the kingdom of heaven. Heaven forbid, with our bidden offerings. So drink, my priests, and be God intoxicated, and have your fill of love. Baruch Hashem.